Hey people of the internet, I'm Nostalgic Dave, and welcome back to Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. That did not sound good. Detention Center, Visitor's Room. Hi. What voice did I give you again?
Well, hello! I didn't expect anyone to visit me in such a dank place as this. It's really quite moving. Not! You stinking liar! I hope you die! If you come to laugh, yes, laugh at the fall in Miss May.
No, that's not why I'm here. No, not really. There's something I wanted to ask.
Unfortunately, there is nothing I want to be asked. Haven't you done enough questioning, you spiky head?
Is that supposed to be offensive? Here we go again. Please, you're scaring the security guard.
So, what is it you wish to ask of me, then, huh?
For starters, how did you get to be so totally whacked? Alright. About the man who stayed with you in the hotel room. Can you tell me about him? Where is he? Come on!
No way, Jose!
Maybe if I had something to get her to talk. Why did you place the wiretap in Mia's phone?
Ah! When you say it like that, it sounds so cold, so criminal.
That's because it's a crime, you nincompoop. Tapping people's phone is a crime, Miss May.
Oh, and I suppose you learned that in lawyer school, hmm?
No, that's kind of a given.
Creep!
Someone is impossible to talk to. Say, why are you so angry? I mean, you don't look like a bad person.
Oh, that does it! Bottom-feeding, scum-sucking lawyer!
Bottom? What does that even mean? Can't tell. Does she have a thing against lawyers or just against me? Well, there is literally nothing I could do here right now, so let's get out of here. Looks like forensics is taking the day off today. Detective Gumshoe is nowhere in sight. The police really gave this place a working over. I doubt there are any valuable clues left. Suppose it can't hurt to take a look around, though. I mean, sure. You couldn't cram more legal books in here even if you wanted to. All the cases that the chief worked on are filled here. Are some of the files missing? Nah, I'm imagining things. That seems a bit odd. Mia's desk. Perfectly clean, as always. The only thing it's missing is Mia. Mia's favorite potted plant. I guess I'll have to water it now. Yeah, probably. The sky's blue, and so am I. There's that hotel right across the way. An old movie poster. Apparently, this was the first movie that made Mia cry when she saw it. I'll have to check it out one of these days. I'm trying to be thorough because... So I just finished this game on my own time, including the fifth one, which is kind of a bonus one, for those who don't know. There are a total of five. Four have the main story, and then the fifth one's kind of a bonus. I finished the bonus, and I needed to literally do everything to be able to beat it. And I still needed a guide! Yeah, it's kind of complicated, so kind of learn from that. Just scan everything if you can. Go to the Gatewater Hotel. Oh, welcome, sir. Your voice, I remember.
Quite the performance today, if I dare say so myself.
Thanks. Sorry for putting you on the spot like that.
No, not at all, sir. Your efforts today can only help the Gatewater's rep, as they say.
Meaning...
our reputation will swell as the hotel where the murderer used a wiretap.
Oh, I mean... I guess?
There is a way you can look at it that way, I guess. Because, I mean, the murderer... I mean, she helped the murderer, so technically, yeah. In the long haul, the murderer did do that.
We can charge a premium for the room, of course. It will be great for business, sir.
No, it won't. Unless you have a horror attraction hidden somewhere in the hotel, no, it won't. Whoa! Miss May hasn't been charged for the murder.
I, too, will become famous. The bellboy who brought the murder, Oh, my lord.
This kid's an idiot. Why do I feel like we're both stuck in the same bad dream?
So, you are on a guest. Please let me know if there's anything I can bring you.
Alright. Now I know what to do, but I'm gonna ask him everything anyway. About Miss May.
Oh, huh? Sir, not to boast, but I knew the moment I saw her. She'd do it, I said.
Do what?
I'm starting to think the most suspicious person here is this guy. I wanted to ask you about the man who was with Miss May.
Ah, yes. He struck me as a real lady killer, if you'll pardon the expression.
Okay, Capcom.
I knew it from the moment I saw him, sir. He and I are the same ilk. We both carry the scent of danger.
There we are in total agreement, Mr. Psycho Bellboy.
If you had a photo of the man, I'm quite sure I could identify him.
A photo? Okay. Could you tell me about the hotel?
Absolutely! And on that subject, I have an excellent idea, sir. Currently, this hotel is known as the Gatewater. I propose that we add a subtitle.
A subtitle? Murder Man. Oh my god. Do you want to turn it into a horror attraction or something?
Well, what do you think?
Sure. Whatever floats your boat. Or tea set. Whatever, same thing.
What was the point of this?
Huh. Looks like Grossberg is out for today. Again. Maybe he's avoiding me for some reason. First of all... What the hell? Wait a sec. Wasn't there a giant painting on the... Yes, there was. Hence my what the hell. It wasn't Marvin. It was a fisherman. Of all three of these, it was the fisherman. Wasn't it? It wasn't a very memorable painting, anyhow. What's this? Old photos? There are two lying here. Something's been written in pencil on the backs. DL6 incident. Exhibit A, DL6 incident. Exhibit B. Let's take a look at these. What's A? I'm sure I've seen this person somewhere. Perhaps I'll borrow this photo. I'm sure no one will miss just one little photo. And it might be valuable. It might be a valuable clue. I'll take it for now. That's not the photo I wanted. I actually completely forgot which was which. A photo lies on the desk. Maybe I should switch it with the one I took. Yeah, swap photos. I think I'll swap them. And let's get out of here. Go back to the Gatewater Hotel. Hi! I got something for you. Take a look at this photo.
That's him, detective.
I'm a lawyer.
Oh, I know that. I just wanted to say detective once. You know how it is.
No. No, I don't.
Without a doubt, that is the man who checked in with Miss April May. How about I write in a affidavit?
Oh, my lord. I've never been able to say that first try, ever.
Affidavit. Swearing that that's him.
An affidavit? This guy's way too excited about this. Fine.
Have at it.
Yes! I've always wanted to write an affidavit, sir. From henceforth, I will be known as the bellboy who swore the affidavit.
Just hurry up and write it.
Not even Miss May can play dumb to this. Well, that tells me where I need to go next.
You again? Can't you take a hint and stay gone?
Hey, the only reason I'm back here is because you won't talk to me.
Oh, so it's my fault now?
Yeah, kinda.
You don't just have spiky hair, you also have a spiky heart.
That does it. When this case is done, I'm shaving my head. No. Hey! Did you have a look at this?
What's that?
Bubbles affidavit. It tells us everything he saw. Such as the man you checked in with. Who was most definitely this guy. Yeah, that proves it. Now I'm getting somewhere. Well, I've got Siri to answer this question. I'm gonna ask her for a random number. If the number ends up being odds, I'll do ease her fears. I'm pretty sure this is the one to move forward. However, I can see both of them doing it, so I'm curious about this, but let's find out what happens. Give me a random number. Okay, I'm pushing her. This is it. All or nothing. Time to do a little bluff. No use playing dumb. If indeed that's an act. If you don't talk, I'm taking this info to the press.
What?!
Even though he should have been witness to murder, your little friend was missing. I'm sure the press would have a field day with his reputation.
Fine! I'll talk! You win, lawyer.
Yes! Man, that felt good! Okay, so either way around it ends up here. It's great to be alive.
Why are you pumping your fists in the air?
Oh.
Nothing?
Now, tell me about the man you were with.
That man? He's my boss. Brent Wright. President of the Information Gathering Conglomerate.
My god, that word. These words today, man. What's with them?
BLUECORP.
Red, white. Of BLUECORP. Really, Capcom?
Information Gathering? Well, I suppose you could call it a detective agency.
So this is the man that was with you the night of the murder.
I'm scared to talk. I don't want to end up like her.
It's okay. I'll just ask Mr. Wright I'll ask myself these questions! Hey, me! What happened? Well, this is what happened, me. I'll ask Mr. White himself. Can you tell me where BLUECORP is located? Mr. Red White, at last. Finally, a lead on this guy. If April May couldn't have done it, that leaves him. Time to take action. Bellboy's affidavit discarded. Affidavit. So, no. No. Let's go to BLUECORP. September 7th, BLUECORP, Inc. CEO's office. What's with the surreal decor? Welcome! Please furnish me with the title of your personage.
What the?
Your name. What's your name? I was just inquiringly asking the title that you go by.
Wright. Phoenix Wright.
Inquiringly? Mr. Wright, is it? Right, I see. Splendiferous! Perhaps I have intimidated you with my giantesque vocabulary.
Just a little. What is this guy's problem?
I'm Red White, CEO of BLUECORP. You know, corporate expansion official. I know what it means. My business dealings bring me into contact with the elite of the elite. So I'm afraid I am not used to conversing with the worldly challenge.
What a fruitcake. You know, just because I don't know what certain words mean doesn't mean I'm abstractly idiotic in it. I'm not that stupid.
Let me guess. You're an attorney fresh out of law school, are you not? That's the only explanation for why you would come to meet me like this.
What does he mean by that?
No matter. So what business does a mighty lawyer have with a man such as myself?
Yipes. This guy's arrogance meter is off the scale. Miss May is an employee of BLUECORP, is she not?
Correct! She was my secretariat. What a shock it was to hear what she had done.
What she has done? You mean the wiretap?
Indeed! She is paid to answer phones. Tapping them is not in her job description. She just gathered information for us as part of her duties. But I assure you, we do not condone illegal methods.
The company might not, but I'm sure you don't. Or you don't care.
I can't speak! Shut up!
It is ineffable that she would do this.
Sounds like he's trying to turn Miss May into a scapegoat. On the night of the murder, were you in April May's hotel room?
Who can say? I seldom pay attention to mundane details such as time and place. My motto is, don't worry, be happy.
Wow. You must really like that song, then. I sound so monotone. Not really. But shut up! Still, Mr. White, the hotel bellboy has stated on the record that he does remember you very clearly.
No matter. The bellboy can say what he pleases. I still won't talk to you. If you want me to speak, put me on the witness stand.
Okay, fine.
Edgeworth!
Although I doubt you'd be capable of doing that.
This is a good question, actually. Why didn't the prosecution call him as a witness? You should have seen the same thing as April May.
Oh ho ho! The police! The courts! To me, they are mere toys, playthings for my amusement.
What kind of company is BLUECORP anyway?
Ah, excellent question. We buy and sell various kinds of information. We are a company of the future. You might say we are the future.
I sure as hell hope not. That just sounds creepy.
In just 10 years, I built this business up into the grand office you see now. Ah, in case you were wondering, BLUECORP was named after the color blue.
No!
I, Red White of BLUECORP, as founder and CEO, named it so. And why, you ask?
Because you like the color blue, I'm assuming? Yeah.
Fantabulistic, is it not?
Not really. It's obviolistic. That's a word. But neither is yours, so... there's something that's been bothering me.
Yes, what might that be?
A big painting on the wall over there. I've seen it before. You know, I've actually seen that painting before.
Oh?
Just yesterday, actually.
Your point being?
My point is simple. Rather, my question is simple. Why is that painting
I can't speak! Why is that painting hanging on your wall?
Mr. Wrong, was it?
Right. And no. I see that kind of joke made way too often in this game, by the way.
It appears you do not fully grasp your position here. I ask again, who are you?
What? I'm a lawyer.
No, my feeble friend, a mere lawyer. Worth nothing, zilch, zippo, nada. Just like that, sorry, excuse for an attorney, Grody Burger.
Grody Burger? Oh, for the love of... What? Ugh! Did he just hit me? He punched me.
Well, Mr. Lawyer, what will you do, eh? Charge me with assault? Charge away, I welcome it. For it is you who will be found guilty.
Really? Really?
Heed my exposition. The police, the courts, they all do my bidding.
So you say. But I wonder, is that kind of control really possible?
I don't expect you to understand. It is a world beyond your comprehension.
That was like a yawn within me trying to say, use this voice. I yawn a lot when I use that kind of voice. It's kind of hard to do without yawning.
You came here from Grody Burgers, I presume?
Mr. Grossbergs?
Yeah. Then you must ask him, why is it that this painting of his hangs here? Perhaps then he will tell you. Perhaps he will explain how a man can live life purely for personal profit. Go now, skedaddle. There's nothing more to discuss.
Not for the love of Pete. Fine! Hi, Grossberg. Huh? I don't think he's noticed me standing here. Maybe I should clear my throat.
Don't be Jehoshaphat!
Oh, you.
What's wrong? You look so pensive, like an old man at the end of his days.
I'm not senile yet.
Just thinking about this whole mess. Something's really bothering him. That much is clear. Man, the picture's gone. So, I paid BLUECORP a visit.
Oh, I see. Mr. Grossberg.
Mr. Grossberg. I have to admit something has been bothering me.
Oh, what is it? Well, odds with it, my boy.
You see, it's just... It could be any of these, really. The painting. Mr. Grossberg, sir. There was a giant painting hanging there the other day. Was there not? The one you said you had no intention of parting with? Well, I saw it. Today. Not in here. It was in the CEO's office at BLUECORP. Red White's office.
So, you noticed. Suppose I should have guessed you would. It is a large painting.
Okay, I'm not gonna do that voice. Mr. Grossberg, I know you and Mr. White are connected somehow.
Connected, you say?
Yes, and I know what it is. He's blackmailing you.
You're lovers!
That would have been an interesting one to go by, actually. And knowing Capcom's sense of humor, that probably would have led to something like that. Mr. White has something on you, doesn't he? Blackmail. Yep. I think that painting is fairly gaudy proof.
Very well. This may be the chance I've been waiting for. Maybe it's time to get this off my chest so I can finally rest easy again. After all, you were me as understudy. Perhaps it was fate.
What's he talking about?
Red White is a man who makes his living through intimidation. BLUECORP is a company that excels in finding people's weaknesses, I'm afraid. I've been paying them for 15 years now.
15 years?
All because of the DL6 incident, as you may have guessed.
Name on the back of those photographs.
Is this suspected? I cannot stand in defense of Maya because of this. Maya would have destroyed me if I did.
Not if you found him guilty, because then he would literally be able to do nothing. So that's the connection.
It's hard for me to tell you this, my boy. But arresting Red White will be nigh on impossible.
Impossible? Why?
He has eyes. He has information on everyone.
Eyes would have worked too in that statement, actually.
It gives him an iron grip. He owns judges, attorneys, prosecutors, police, and politicians.
What?
They are bound, unable to do harm to themselves, and therefore to him. Don't look at me like that. What you see is nothing more than a weight of many years.
Okay. What is the DL6 incident?
DL6 is nothing more than the sword and code the police gave the case. It was 15 years ago now. I received a request from a spirit medium. Her name was Misty Faye.
Faye.
Indeed. She was Mia's mother. She had been investigating a murder at the bequest of the police. And she failed. As a result, the police called her a fraud.
This is what Maya was talking about the other day.
I did all I could for her, and in the end cleared her of wrongdoing. That murder case, however, remains unsolved to this day. That case is the DL6 incident.
But why were you blackmailed over this, Mr. Grossberg?
The DL6 incident was top secret at the time. It made sense. The police didn't want people to know they were using a medium. They couldn't let people know. But one person found out. I told him.
Why? You told White?
He offered me riches. It is an embarrassment to me now. Because I talked, the police were mocked far and wide. In secret, they began looking for the one who sold them out. Of course, White heard about it, and he came to me. Only this time, the offer was blackmail.
I see.
White controls the law of this country as he sees fit. Yet, if you would still challenge him, have a close look at Mia's office. She followed his every move for years. She may have recorded something of White she found.
I could ask him about the trial and stuff, but I know for a fact that it becomes, you know what, whatever. We'll talk to him about it anyway. So you came to see the trial?
Yes, I did. Something was bothering me all last night, you see. Couldn't get a wink of sleep.
Really? What was that?
Well, you see, it's just Mia's sister, that poor girl. My boy, I owe you my thanks, truly. I don't know what I would have done if things had gone poorly for the girl.
I asked before, but why did you refuse a request for defense? I think I have a right to know. Yeah?
Okay.
We already found out why. We already found out why. Kinda figured he was going to refuse. Let's see, where to next? Nope! Wait a minute. I might be missing something here. It's the same song. Sorry, sir, I borrowed this.
Ah, so it was you, my boy.
Who's this man?
It's a long story. I'll be needing that back now.
He doesn't want to talk about it for some reason. I better give him back this photograph. Photograph returned to Mr. Grossfoot. I feel like I'm missing something. Well, I'm obviously missing something. Apparently Miss May is in questioning. I doubt they'll let me talk to her today. You already talked to her today, dude. It's funny. Looking at this room, it seems so normal. Hard to imagine a murder took place here. Mr. Grossberg said there would be clues. Maybe I should have a look. I know exactly where to look! All the cases the chief ever worked on are filed here. They're in alphabetical order. Let's take a look. Which file should I look at? T through Z. Because W.
I know how to word.
T, U. I know. W. White. The entire W section is missing. Was it taken? Order. Which file? A through I. Let's see. A record is in this file. Let's see if there's A record in this file that catches my eye. Wow. Shame. Shame on you, Capcom! A, B, F, Misty Faye. That's Mia and Maya's mother. Should I take a look? Read it. I've tarnished the Fae name, leaving only these words, my mother vanished. I was determined to find the ones who had made my mother blame herself in this way. Using the power that runs in my family, I held an audience with the dead. Finally, the names of two men surfaced. One was Marvin Grossberg, a lawyer who sold my mother's information for riches. The other was the man who sold that information to the press. This parasite, who makes his fortune on threats and coercion. His name is... The record stops there. So Mia knew Grossberg. His name is Red White. He's the chief ever worked on. Yeah. Let's see, J through S. Any more. Maybe I'll just skim some of this. Just to be safe, yeah, let's do that. Well, no harm in flipping through a bit, I guess. Biggest parts here at the end of... At the end in S. Suicide. Ew. She has a collection of suicide reports. There's politicians, policemen. There's writing on most of these in pencil. White. This is Mia's handwriting. Wait, I get it. Mia thought he was involved in these suicides. White drove them all to... I can use these newspaper... I can use these newspaper clippings.
Let's find the most disturbing one. You will be caught, White. You will be caught.
Newspaper clipping added to the court record. And now to go discuss this with White.
Well, aren't you persistent?
Sorry, but there's something I have to ask you.
Mr. Lawyer, I really hate having to repeat myself, but it seems the message has not yet penetrated your thick skull. Stop bothering me! If you try my patience further, I fear a nasty accident might occur. Do I make myself clear?
Transparent. You wish, a-hole. This is the only clue that Mia left me. I better make this one count. Mr. White, see this? It's an article describing the suicide of a politician. He was embezzling secret government funds. Then one day, word got leaked to the press. The very next day, he took his own life.
This concerns me, Hal.
I found this article in Mia's office.
Miss Mia?
She had a file filled with articles like this. Every one of them was labeled with a single word. White. Mr. White, I know what you did to this politician. You blackmailed him.
Blackmail?
Not just him, either. You were threatening and coercing hundreds of others. You were involved in all the suicide cases that Mia investigated. This company is built on blackmail. I'm right, aren't I?
What a bizarre accusation! Mr. Wrong? What is it that you should be doing now? Investigating me? No! I think not! You should be searching for the one who killed Miss Mia.
Secretary's office, hello?
Mr. Wrong will be leaving now.
Yes, sir. I'll send someone right away.
Wait a second, Mr. White. You're wrong. You're wrong, Mr. Wright. White. Good gory!
Excuse me?
What I should be doing now is going after you.
Just what are you insinuating?
Mia was on to you. She was keeping tabs. For this reason, you had April May tapping her phone. Then, Mia was murdered, and all the documents about you mysteriously disappeared. So, culprit would be... Even a child could work it out, Mr. White. You did it.
Secretary's office.
We won't be needing an escort for Mr. Wrong. Instead, please connect me to the public prosecutor's office.
Of course, sir. One moment, please.
What are you doing? White.
White, that's you? What are you doing calling me at a time like this?
By the voice, you can probably already tell who I think this is. No, I'm wrong.
White! What are you doing calling me at a time like this?
Hello, Chief Prosecutor. I've changed my mind. I want to testify tomorrow.
What's this about?
The Mia Fey case. I witnessed the murder, you see?
Why would you turn it down in the first place, then?
And thus, as a very important witness, I would like to testify.
What? Why now? I thought you said you didn't want to go to court.
Quietude! I told you I changed my mind, didn't I? Oh, and one other thing. Send the police over here. Right away. Man is standing in front of me. Looks dazed, but could be violent.
Excuse you? Excuse you, sir?
What man?
Are you even listening? The executioner, the hatchet man, the liquidator, the killer man!
What?
Mr. White, this isn't another one of those...
Chief Prosecutor! I do not believe you are in a position to freely offer your opinions to me, correct? I'm telling you to send the police now. Did I not tell you, Mr. Wong? You are a mere lawyer. As is Miss Mia.
How dare you?
I'll point the finger at you, and you will be tried as Miss Mia's killer. The case is as good as settled. No lawyer of any worth will defend you. I have friends in the local lawyers association, you see?
Friends? Bullcrap.
You'll be given a lawyer so stupendously inept that they make even you look competent.
I feel faint.
Detective Gumshoe reporting, sir. Ah, Butt. Harry Butt.
Right, actually. Phoenix Wright. And my friend's name is Larry.
Oh, right. Sorry, pal. Butt was the murderer, right?
No! We've gone over this already.
Detective Gumshoe, I present to you the man who killed Miss Mia Fey.
What?
Take this despicable human being into custody. Farewell, Mr. Wrong.
Well, I don't have to do his voice anymore. For now. I can't believe it's only been a day since the first trial. My trial begins tomorrow. White's going to set a trap for me. And the prosecution will be in on it. Of course. Edgeworth included. An attorney was assigned to me by the state yesterday. I refused. I had an idea.
Right. Mr. Wright!
Maya! Great, they let you out of detention.
Just now, yes. It's all thanks to you.
Now I'm afraid we switched places.
What? You mean you...
I explained what had happened to Maya.
I don't believe it. How many people does that man need to destroy before he's satisfied? My mother, my sister, and now you. This has gone too far! Mr. Wright, please tell me, is there anything I can do?
Well... Help me break out of here! Well, I think, if I remember correctly, the plan would actually be... I'm gonna defend myself, so... I'm not gonna try to tease her for this or anything. Well, you could cheer for me in court.
Cheer for you? You mean, I could cheer later?
1, 2, 3, 4, who are we cheering for? Right! Huh? Yeah, like that.
Alright, leave it to me.
Huh?
I better go get a
Oh my god! Oh, come on! Wait!
What?
I'm kidding. It was a joke. No, okay, so no matter what I pick, it's a joke. Great. No, really, I was kidding. But thanks. It's good to know you're on my side. And there really isn't anything you can do for me anyway.
But I can't just sit here and do nothing. I've got to give that man a piece of my mind.
Just a piece? Okay. Then come to the trial tomorrow.
Okay, I'll be there. I'll show them a thing or two.
Alright! Times may change, yet with crime, it's the same old story. In fact, it's gotten worse. Lengthy court proceedings are no longer realistic. Beginning a few years ago, a limit of 3 days was put on initial court trials. Almost all finished in a day, most with a guilty verdict. I never thought I would end up in the defendant's chair myself for this case. With the true culprit appearing as the star witness, this is it. Tomorrow it's me or him. Alright, so I'm going to leave this video here. We will either finish up or do half of the trial tomorrow. I don't know which it's going to be. We'll find out. Well, not tomorrow, but whenever I decide to upload the next video, that next time. That way. Next time. Anyway, yeah, I'm going to leave this video here. So thank you guys so much for watching this episode. If you liked it, push that like button in so far you can't see it anymore. If you really liked it, consider subscribing to the channel. Got any suggestions for me? Let me know in the comments below. Or if you want to check out any footage I've done in the past or I'm currently working on now, click the box down over there. Or if you missed anything in this playlist or you want to just check out the rest of it in general anyway, just click the box across from my head over here. In the meantime, I'm out, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!